Today's videos are brought to you by Ranjan Motors, located at 139 Tutukamina Street, Kahuwala. Come check them out if you're interested in getting a new or used ride. How's it going, my car dudes? Liam here from the Car Dudes channel, and today I present to you all a review of this 2014 Toyota Prado TX. Now, if you've been watching me from at least 2019 onwards, you might recognize this car. This is actually our old 2014 Toyota Prado that we actually traded for our red Raptor over there, as you can see. And yeah, that's proof that it's ours, or was ours, plate number. So this is the first time that this car has been at the dealership since I started coming back here to film. The owner of the dealership actually has been using this car, so I could not pass up the opportunity to make a review on it, because, I mean, come on, who's ever gonna... What are the odds that you get to review... What are the odds that you're a car reviewer and you get to review one of your previously owned cars? So I'm not gonna pass up that opportunity. I'm going to do it. So anyways, sit back, relax, and enjoy. Starting off with the trunk. Now, the Prado is famous for having a glass popper. They can open like this. It does have a normal little pull-up tab, but ours broke off, so that's nice. But yeah, you have that, or if you want to open the full gate. It's a swing back gate, not a lift up. And there you go, you have a vast, massive cargo space. This does have the power third row seats that do come up. You adjust them through the buttons over here. I've already shown them on a newer Prado, they're exactly the same. I showed the mechanism and everything. I'm not gonna do it here because there's a carpet in the way and stuff in the way, so I'll leave it as it is. And here we have a bit of storage to put like maybe recovery shackles and whatnot. And in here we have our jack tools. Coming to the back seat of the Prado, the Prado has been praised many times for having a very spacious back seat. This seat has put in a position that I will be comfortable in. I am 6'3" almost. My knees are up against the seat, but they are scalped, so they're not too bad, and I can put my feet under the seat. Headroom is pretty good, even though this one has a sunroof, it's still not too bad. Opening here, we have an armrest with two cup holders. Overall, it's not a bad back seat. Here's the key fob for the Prado. This is Toyota's older style key design. Our lock, unlock, and our glass popper. This one does have smart key access. Right now the car is unlocked. To lock it, touch the little root pattern on either the driver's side or passenger side door handle. One beep indicates locking, and to unlock it, just grab the back of the door handle and the car will unlock. Also, you gotta make sure that the key fob is on you. The exterior color is known as Blizzard Pearl. Comes with a beige and gray leather interior. Along with that smart key access system, the Prado does have push button start. So, just make sure you have the key fob in the vehicle. Put your foot on the brake and press the start button to start it. Has a four-spoke, hydraulically assisted leather and wood-wrapped steering wheel. Fairly smooth power steering. Has a four-speed automatic transmission with low gear selection. Does have a backup camera. It does have a side view camera on that mirror over there, and also has a front facing camera mounted on the grill. Alright, so let's go ahead and turn on the automatic headlamps, the high beams and the fog lights, the hazards. In typical Toyota fashion, all four windows are fully automatic. We'll pop the hood and we'll go ahead and check out the exterior. This Prado has a 2.7-liter four-cylinder producing 163 brake horsepower and 170 foot-pounds of torque, has a 0 to 100 time of 12.5 seconds, and a top speed of 173 kilometers per hour. Now we all know how much I praise Prados. Yes, alright, it's because we owned this one for 5.5 years, but it's also because, well, they simply are just great cars. They're practical, they're well-mannered on the road, safe, capable, and being a Toyota, it will hold its value and will never, ever break down. Seriously, these things are tanks. And we got 90% of the money we paid for it back when we traded this thing for the Raptor. Low-key, I do really regret selling it. Not to say that I don't like the Raptor, I do, I love it. Maybe it's because the Prado had so much sentimental value to me. But if it were my money, I'd have traded our Q7 instead. Win-win for everyone. A reliable family hauler that doesn't depreciate that much, and also a badass redneck truck that scares everyone. What more could you want? Now, Prados like this one can go from anywhere between 15 to 18 million rupees, depending on the spec, mileage, and the condition. Mileage isn't a huge factor though, considering these things can be driven into the ground and still be ready for the next family camping trip into the wilderness. However, if you are going to buy one, try to get a 4-liter V6 model. The 4-cylinder models like this one are ridiculously slow. They're so slow, in fact, that if you did a 0 to 100 run, you'd start growing gray hair by the time you reach 90. It's that bad. The diesels are okay, but really the best engine is the 4-liter V6. Coming to the interior, power windows, locks, and mirrors. It's a full power driver's seat with lumbar support. Down here we have your accelerator and brake, our fuel cap release, our hood release. This is our headlight washers, and this is to adjust the ambient lighting from underneath the door panels. Power mirror controls, like I said. Coming to the interior, dual zone climate control. It is automatic. Individual temperatures of the driver and passenger, but we have a central central zone and central fan speed. Of course, famous Toyota clock with the famous Toyota H, M, and 00 buttons. That's how you can tell that a Toyota is actually a Toyota if it has this clock. It doesn't have this clock. No, it's not a Toyota. Sorry. Very simple to use. Our auto right here. Again, it's pretty intuitive, very simple, and the buttons are nice and big. Buttons and knobs are nice and big because they were designed so that you could use them with gloves. Coming to the stereo, this has a standard 6-speaker Kenwood head unit, but shortly after we bought it, we actually did put some good quality Rockford Fosgate speakers, which definitely make a huge difference. Take a listen for yourself. Definitely sounds good. If your car has this Kenwood head unit, I definitely recommend you put some Rockford Fosgate speakers because it really does make a huge difference. It's amazing. So I'm not gonna go too in depth into the infotainment system because this is an aftermarket system. I believe the Prado of this era from 2013 onwards, which is when this facelift came out, I believe it came with an infotainment system called Toyota Touch 2. Again, I'm not 100% sure on that, so please correct me if I'm wrong. But yeah, this is just an aftermarket system because soon after the refresh in 2013, when importers, or when people who imported them, they didn't come with a radio. So people who imported these cars had to fit them manually. It has Bluetooth telephone, that sort of stuff. It's just not Toyota. So there's that, and actually the volume knob, the volume down button is broken off. How convenient, like the day before we traded this in, it broke off. So yeah, it's very, very convenient. Coming down here, we have two cup holders along with a little storage space. I assume Toyota designed that for the key. We primarily used it to keep our gate quicker. This is a four-wheel drive control, so you rock it in four high all the time, or all-wheel drive. You twist this. This will put it into, this will lock the center differential, as you can see over there. And then put the car into neutral, push and turn. This car will go, it'll go into four low, and it'll kick off the traction control. This is the basic off-road setting system. The more higher level trim Prados came with a gigantic knob that came with a sort of terrain response type interface. You could control it on this screen right here. I'll come to that in a bit. Coming down here, we have a power outlet and we have heated seats. These are typical Toyota heated seats too, in the sense that you can adjust them very specifically. Like, no, that's too little. No, that's too much. Oh, that's just right. So there's that. We have a fairly large size center cubby, so it's like you open it once, there's a bit of space, open it up again, there's loads. And under here there's a little knob down there, I don't know if you guys can see it, but you twist that and it can sort of bring some of the AC air into the, basically doubling it as a cool box. Not necessarily a cool box, it won't chill your drinks, but it'll definitely cool it. And here, this is a massive storage space. I remember when we took long road trips in this car, you could fit absolutely anything in there. A bag of chips, Doritos, anything you want in there. It's just humongous. As far as interior quality goes, it's Toyota, typical Toyota, and with the 150 series Prado, Toyota tried to make this feel a bit more upmarket, more luxurious. So there's some really nice soft touch materials here and there on the dashboard. Of course, this is, that's hard touch. I can understand that because, well, there's a speaker up here, so that's fair. Nice soft touch materials, even on the door panels, nice soft leatherette. But going further down, it does show its utilitarian side. I mean, that's not really much of a surprise to me because it is an off-roader. So you will find that. It's really not that big of a deal. One thing I did notice, that if you rest your leg against here, this does start to rattle a bit. Typically when my dad drove this, he usually rests his leg right this, or my driver. So it does start, it does loosen up a bit and does rattle a little bit. It's not too big of a deal. But interior quality is pretty good. In terms of comfort wise, the seats, they're very comfortable, very nice soft seats. But on long road trips, I remember I would get sort of lower back pain, like around this area here. If you do have heated seats, just put those on and the problem will go away. So there's that. Now, coming to the gauge cluster, the Toyota updated this gauge cluster for the 2013 facelift. So we have our tach on the left, along with a temperature gauge. On the right, we have our speedo and our fuel gauge. And in the center, we have this new for 2013 color display. This gave us all sorts of information. So right now it's showing our fuel range, our average fuel consumption, which with this engine is just atrocious. It's horrible. I'm sorry. That's like our overall fuel range, our average speed, our drive time, nothing at all. And this is really useful. This helps you see which way the wheels are pointing when you're off-road, so you don't like rip off a CV joint or anything like that. Yeah, pretty simple. Also, if you press this button right here, you can turn on and off second start. So if you press enter right here, I'll turn it on. Basically, it'll make the car start in second gear. So say if you're going up a sand dune, or you're going through like some really slippery mud, or you just want to get a bunch of torque, second start will do the job for you. This being the TX trim, you do get nice accents of wood grain here and there. I love how this sort of, the bolster is half wood, half leather. Super nice touch. Some more wood grain down here and along the door. They did away with the wood grain here for the 2017 refresh. Don't know why. Even in the top of the range trim, it's just this black plastic. Again, don't know why they did that. Glove box is also a pretty big size, and usually that would be a USB port down here, but for some reason with this one, when we bought it, it had a USB port in here. So there's that.
And coming up here, we have a little mirror. When we first got this, I thought this was the coolest thing ever. It was, I don't know, I found that really cool. And then we have a sunglass container in here. Our dome lights, if it's in the center, then the lights will come on when you open the door. And we have a full power sunroof, which does tilt and slide. I'm not gonna open it because, well, it's raining. Alrighty. That's about it for this one. We'll turn her off. Well guys, thank you all so much for watching my review on our old Toyota Prado. I'm so glad I decided to do this. I really miss this thing. I do know the person who bought our old A8. He's a good friend of mine. So I'm going to try and get a review of that also. Try and make it a bit of a trend. Reviewing past or previously owned cars you had. That would be cool. Anyways, thank you all so much for watching and I will see you guys in my next video. Drive safely till then.